everyone to Waialua United Church of Christ. My name is Priscilla Schulteis, and I join our guest pastor, George Keamo, and our worship team in leading today's service. We are happy you have joined us for worship, whether you are here in person or joining us online. Let's turn to your neighbor and greet them with a warm welcome. For those of you watching online, give us a wave or a shaka. Visitors who would like to be recognized. We always happy for new visitors. We would like to thank Audrey Ray Regola for the beautiful altar flowers. And now let us prepare our hearts for worship as we light the candles, open the Bible, and listen to the gathering music by Edwin Ramones.
Please rise for our call to worship.
Please join me in reading our call to worship. The words can be found in your bulletin or on the screen. I will love thee, O Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. I will praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart.
I will be glad and rejoice in thee. I will sing praise to thy name.
Praise ye the Lord, and give thanks unto the Lord.
The Lord,
for he is good,
and his mercy endureth forever.
Let us continue with our prayer and invocation in unison, followed by the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray. Father God, you are holy and worthy of our praise. We worship you for who you are, the creator of the universe, the living God, and the loving Father. We praise you for salvation, for reconciliation, for redemption through Jesus Christ. We honor you this morning with our hearts, with our voices, and with our hands. In Jesus' most precious name, we pray in the words he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning, church family. We are so glad that you are here. And as our call to worship says, we will praise the Lord with my whole, with our whole hearts. And praising the Lord is not only just the heart, it's your whole body, your whole being. So let's join in our praise songs. And this song that we're about to sing, we sang it last week, but we want to sing it again so that we get accustomed to it, because this is a beautiful song, and we will continue singing as we sing the Lord who is good and holy forever. Thank you.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Hallelujah. For the children's message today, I'm going to have my beautiful wife to come and share with you guys. Lana. Yeah. So all you kids, please come forward, I believe. Am I doing it correctly?
Yep, you are.
Come to the front.
Our emotions are a gift from God. In Ecclesiastes 3:1-3, it says, "For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to weep, a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek, and a time to lose." Emotions are a gift from God and natural for us to feel them, pleasant and unpleasant. Most think of anger as a negative emotion, but really it is God's mechanism of protecting. It lets us know that something could be wrong. Emotions are a part of our spiritual makeup. In Psalms 56:8, he tells us, it says that God is fully aware of all our feelings. When we are crying, be assured that He places our tears in a bottle and remembers them. God encourages us to bring our emotions to Him. In Philippians 4:6-7, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Whatever emotions that you hold, every emotion, pleasant or unpleasant, are gifts from God. Amen.
Amen.
But in all things, prayer, supplication, but most importantly, thanksgiving. And it says be anxious for nothing, but it means to be careful. In the King James Version, it says be careful for nothing. No worry about nothing. Be careful for nothing. Because we serve an honorable, big God. If you know your God, you're not going to be careful for nothing. You're not going to be anxious for anything. You're not going to worry about anything. Anything else? Buddy, let's go. Father God, we just thank you. We thank you and appreciate you, Lord God. We thank you for your love, your mercy, your kindness, your goodness, Lord God. We thank you for being who you are, Lord God. And Father God, we just lift up the sister who's going into surgery tomorrow, Lord God. Right now, in the name of Jesus, we claim him. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Father God, we thank you for touching the doctors or the upper, whatever, the doctors, the nurses, Lord God. Guide their hands, Lord God, in whatever they do. But Lord God, we just thank you for healing right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. We stand firmly on your promises that by your stripes, she is healed. Amen. And Father God, I just lift up everyone here, Lord God. Continue to touch their lives, Lord God. Continue to remind them that they are children of a living God, Lord God. Father God, we continue to lift up their homes, Lord God. Father God, in your word it says that you shall supply all our needs according to your riches and glory, Lord God. And we stand firmly on that promise, for you know the needs. I don't, but you do, Lord God. And I just thank you for meeting it right now, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. I thank you right now. Amen.
First scripture lesson today comes from the Old Testament, from the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verses 26 through 28. Then God said, "Let us make humans in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth." So God created humans in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves on the earth." This is the word of God. Our second scripture lesson comes from the New Testament, from the book of Matthew, chapter 28, verses 18 through 20. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." This is the good news. Praise be to you, O Christ.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
My name is Pastor George, and I am here all the way from the island of Wyman, which is right across the mountain over there. But it's a privilege and an honor to be here. As I was going through the book, I had a few times to actually prepare for this dinner, but today started a little bit different. And, you know, the message came, but the message also came this morning. And I could just trust God in my message for today. That it was for me, but it's also for everybody. Good morning, Blake. Good to see you. But anyway, let's open up in prayer. Father God, we just thank you. God, it is an honor and a privilege, Lord God, to be sharing your word, Lord God. Not my word. But Father God, as we go into your word, Lord God, let that be revelation, Lord God. Bring us wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. Holy Spirit, open up our hearts and our minds to hear from you. Not from me, not from anybody else, but directly from you. Father God, I just thank you. Really just thank you. Thank you for this church. Thank you for this people, Lord God. And just thank you for everything that you have done, still doing, and what you're about to do in our ministries over here. In Jesus' name, amen. You know, God's purpose. I was one of the scripture verses that she was sharing about was Genesis 1. The words that God uses is "be fruitful and multiply." Maybe many people look at the word "be" as just one simple word, but it's not. "Be" is a word of empowerment. It's a word of certification that I have prepared you to be fruitful and to multiply. So be fruitful and multiply. You know, the word also says to subdue it, to dominate, have dominion over it. You know what? I just want to go into the word right now. Genesis 1, 26. Genesis 1. If you guys have your Bibles, please turn with us. You guys got to say amen.
Amen.
And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. Whose image we in?
God's.
Amen. So you guys paying attention. Good job. And God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. The biggest thing about this is God gave us a job. God gave us a job, not to just go through life on this earth, just living our life. No, He gave us a job to be fruitful, to multiply, to subdue the earth, to take dominion over the earth. We look at this as we are created in God's image. God created the earth in 6 days while he rested on the 7 days. If we are created in God's image, we are created to be creators or workers or to be fruitful and to multiply. The purpose of this message is actually to remind you guys that you guys have a purpose. When man was created in God's image, he had a purpose. As believers, as Christians, as sons of God, we also have a greater purpose. Never change. The commission is still the same. The Great Commission, if you look at Matthew 28, actually, there is a purpose that we have that God gave us. There is a purpose that Jesus gave us. Genesis 3, we see a fall of man. We see a fall of man. We become separated from God. Our spirit is no longer connected to God. There's none. We have a separation that happens because of the fall of man. So the purpose becomes different. Purpose and our life that we have that relationship with God is different. Mm-hmm. Our purpose never changed. Our purpose to subdue the earth, to be fruitful, and to multiply never changes. When Jesus comes and we accept Jesus Christ in our heart, Jesus Christ gave us a purpose. In fact, let's go into it. Let's read. It's in Matthew. Matthew 28. Matthew 28, verse 18. You guys got to say amen. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the year, until the world. End of the world. Sorry. All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. go ye therefore. A key word is go. Go is a qualifying statement saying that you guys are able, that you have need in you. Go ye therefore. It doesn't say is sit down and wait. No, he's going to go ye therefore, preaching the gospel. It's not to just sit and hold on to, but go. You guys are certified. You guys are qualified. You guys have everything that you guys need. You guys are ready to share the gospel. There is a job that we as believers are called to do, and that is to share God. To make disciples. To bring the truth. It's not a disqualifying statement. It's a qualifying statement. It's like, you wouldn't tell your son to go clean the yard and get enough to clean the yard, right? It's the same thing. When Jesus tells his disciples to go, he's telling us that you guys have everything you need. You have the Holy Spirit. You have Jesus in you. You guys are prepared to go out and preach the gospel. Not to just come into church and, you know, praise God, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Okay, good for a week, come back on Sunday. No, you have to live a lifestyle of sharing who God is, who Jesus Christ is in our life, you know. And most of the time, it's not by words. Most of the time, it's how we live our lives, your actions, how you carry yourself, how you walk, how you talk, how you be. A lot of people, we use this term that you are a walking Bible. For a lot of people who don't know what the Bible is, who never opened the Bible, when you are walking, they are looking at you. Christ should be seen in you. As you walk, talk, work, wherever it is that you are, you should be able to be showing Jesus Christ in your life. Amen?
Amen.
Sorry, a little bit nervous.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
This is my first time seeing you guys. I mean, I watch the service on church. I mean, on YouTube and stuff. I watch it. I have to do my homework. I have to see how the structure, how you guys carry out the things. And I have to do what I needed to do to prepare myself to be ready to be able to pray, to be writing a lot of homework. We had a lot of homework. And it was interesting. I don't usually write down my messages. I usually just go according to what the Holy Spirit says in the Bible. And for me, in this type of structure was a lesson learned, actually. Actually, the pastor that came a couple weeks ago, his name is, I believe he came like 2 weeks ago. And he Paul Skinny.
Yeah.
Yes, him and his wife Vicky, and he told me, watch the videos. Watch the videos. You know, I had to prepare myself. I had to be ready and to see how the church runs. I didn't want to be any, have to be sensitive. Because it's a different, little bit different operation. Because at my church, my mother-in-law is just asking, what's on me got? Well, I don't know. Or we're going to practice it, you know what I mean? But it's just led by the Spirit. And just trust in God. Proverbs 3:5-6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. You need not unto your own understanding, but in all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he shall bring you back. It's talking about it, just acknowledging him. Acknowledging him, everything that we do. And trust him. Sometimes you don't know what you're doing. Sometimes you don't know. Sometimes you get into a rock and a hard place and you don't know what you're doing, but there's only one thing that you can trust God. You know? Yesterday, my friend called me up. Well, last night, actually. He calls me up. He said, oh, there's something wrong with my car. And I'm, like, the worst person that you can call for his own car. I put the lesson clueless in fixing my car. I don't know anything. Talk about good in my house, yes, call me up. Talk about installing cars, yes, call me up. Call me up about cars, don't call me up. But he calls me up and he says that, oh, he need a jump start. I get down there, his car is, his battery is like, his car is, battery is full. Like, it's very charged, the lights on, everything goes on, but it's just not turning over. And it was funny because I started praying on the car. Started praying on myself, God, give me wisdom. And you know, the funny thing is, it wasn't the battery or anything, it was his car. And I remember growing up, my uncle used to whack the starters, whack them so that the thing cranks over. And I did it. I hit the starter a couple of times with this long pipe, started making noise, whack them again, and then it started up. You know, the amazing thing, I just wanted to share that because I wasn't prepared. I didn't know what I was going to say or how I was going to fix them. But you know, there's times in our life that we don't have to know. We just need to trust Him. Just need to lean on Him. Let me continue. Let's turn to Mark 16, 15 and 18. You guys nodded, say amen. And he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils, they shall speak with new tongues, they shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. And they shall recover. Amen?
Amen.
This is the same thing. It's the same thing that go into the world and preach the gospel to every creature, but that he that believeth is baptized and shall be saved. We have a job. It was funny because yesterday what I was talking about is that he needed somebody to help him with his car. We all need, sometimes we need somebody to fix our plumbing. We need somebody to fix our car. We need somebody to clean our yard. We need help somewhere. The world needs help with getting salvation. We're learning Jesus Christ. The world needs, I didn't say a rescue. A rescue, you know. We all have needs, but what the world needs now is a rescue. That is our job, to come out there and point them at the rescue. Not be the rescuer. Be the vessel. The rescuer is Jesus Christ. Our job is just to point them to Jesus Christ, to bring the rescue. You know? But that's our job to, we're more like that. More like the ambulance carrying the paramedics. You know what I mean? That we are delivering Jesus Christ, the source, the salvation, and life. Jesus said he's not the life. He brings life. And life more abundantly. Our job is just to bring our life. Amen? Alright.
Amen.
Let's start to Romans 10. Okay. You guys got to say amen. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Big question. In verse 14. How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? And how shall they preach except they be sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel and of peace,
amen,
and bring glad tidings of good things. But they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Isaiah said, Lord, whose have believed our report? So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Interesting, huh? How then shall they call on him whom they have not believed? How shall they believe in him of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? It's crazy, they say in the final verse, so faith coming by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. How can they have faith if they don't hear the word of God? It is our job to bring the gospel, to bring the word of God. So faith coming by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. It is our job to bring the hearing of God, the word of God. So they can hear and have faith. Amen?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. And you guys turn with me to Romans 18 and 19. All right, guys, I'll get that 50 more scriptures for look through and shall be good for the week. You guys gotta say amen. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the holy glory, with the glory which shall be revealed in us. For the earnest expectation of the creation waited for the manifestations of the Son of God. Amen.
Amen.
His word is saying that whole creation, not just man, but the whole creation, is waiting for the manifestation of the Son of God. This whole creation, this whole world is waiting for us to actually take our place, to take our stand, to stop preaching the gospel, to show Jesus, to stop sharing Jesus Christ in our life, in our life. Not just at church, in our life, in our job, in our home. Every time we must be manifesting the Son of God. Amen. Let Jesus be seen in us. I got 12 more. 2 Corinthians 5, 17 and 18. That's how I say amen. If you don't, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. And all things are of God, who hath reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ, and have given to us the ministry of reconciliation. That is our job, to bring the ministry of reconciliation. Reconciliation is to be reinstated, to have a relationship. Our job is to bring that ministry of reconciliation, bringing that reconciliation right back to God, bringing Jesus Christ, bringing God and us like this, reconciliation. That is our mission, that is our job, and that's what we are called to do. And that is the gospel of bringing Jesus Christ. Last but not least, Matthew 5, 13. Matthew 5, 13 through 16. This is a familiar scripture. That's God saying amen.
Amen.
Ye are the salt of the earth. But if the salt have lost its savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It is henceforth no good for nothing, but to be cast out and to be trodden under foot of men. Ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Amen?
Yeah.
Ye are the salt. Ye are the light. We must let our light shine. Not falsely, Lord. Let them see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Let them see God in you. I used to use this scripture a lot about letting the light so shine. Your light is Jesus Christ in you. Let your light shine. And then you see your good work to glorify your Father in Jesus. Not to glorify you, not because of what you do. Christ did in you so that you can use it. 1 John 4:17 says, as he is, so are we in this earth. You are. Let me ask you guys, are you guys, did you guys accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So as he is, so are we on this earth. Meaning we carry Jesus Christ in us. We manifest the Son of God in our lives, in our walk, in our talk, in everything that we do. So, I'm going to have my wife just move this up. It's a reminder of who Christ is in us, who we are in Christ. I just read the scripture, 2 Corinthians 5:7. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, you are in Christ. Galatians 2:20 is talks about Christ living in me. We are not separate, we are connected. Spirit with God has been reconciled by Jesus Christ. Amen?
Yeah.
That is my message today, that we have a purpose, we have a job, we have something to do, we have a job that we're not here for just nothing. We have a reason and a purpose. Everyone here has a calling and a purpose for Jesus Christ. To live for Christ, to show Christ, to be sons and daughters of the living God. But before I close up, I'm going to have my wife read some of the promises that God has called us.
If you guys can repeat after me, I am a child of God.
I am reconciled to God.
I am reconciled to God.
I am forgiven.
I am qualified.
I am chosen by God.
The Holy Spirit lives on the inside of me.
The Holy Spirit lives on the inside of me.
I have access to God's wisdom.
I have access to God's wisdom.
Knowledge and understanding.
Knowledge and understanding.
I have been justified.
I have been justified.
I have Christ's righteousness.
I have Christ's righteousness.
I am Christ's ambassador.
I am Christ's ambassador.
I am completely forgiven and tenderly loved. I am a sweet fragrance of Christ to God.
I am a sweet fragrance of Christ to God.
I am a temple in which God dwells.
I am a temple in which God dwells.
I am blameless and beyond reproach.
I am blameless and beyond reproach.
I am the salt of the earth and the light of the world.
I am salt of the earth and the light of the world.
I am chosen of Christ to bear fruit.
I am chosen of Christ to bear fruit.
I am a joint heir with Christ.
I am a joint heir with Christ.
I share in His inheritance with Him.
I share in His inheritance with Him.
I am united to the Lord, one spirit with Him. I am a member of the body of Christ. I am hidden with Christ in God.
I am a child of light.
I am sanctified.
I am a member of a chosen race.
I am a royal priesthood.
I am a holy nation.
I am firmly rooted and built up in Christ.
I am born of God, and the evil one cannot touch me.
I have the mind of Christ.
I can approach God with boldness, freedom, and confidence.
I have been rescued from Satan's domain, and I have been transferred to the kingdom of Christ.
I have been made complete in Christ.
I have been established,
anointed and sealed by God.
I am a personal witness of Christ.
I am a citizen of heaven.
And I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Peace,
God.
Hallelujah. Is it possible to have another friend share? You know who I come to? Will you come up to share?
Community center will call me and get food or just hang out and rent the center or whatever, but this is a beautiful place here today. I've known Lana and Polani, we call him Polani, for a long time. I'm actually an evangelist, pastor. I travel over and spread the gospel wherever I go. I'm not the average person who looks at me like, who's this strange guy? Good. I like that people look at me weird kind of. So now with my motto, share the love of God, and you know who lives inside of me. It's who I identify myself with. Amen.
Amen.
It's not a scripted moment. This is a divine moment that God called me up here to share something. We just came to support Him. That's what we do. We travel over and people that we come alongside with or mentor, we support them. That's how we came. So he looked at me and I was like, okay, Lord, here we go. But you see, I like what he shared about your identity. Because if you know who you are in Christ Jesus, you should have always have something to share about Him.
Yes.
Amen.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can be pointed off to our pastor. Pastor, you go pray for one, tell somebody else to go. If you're a believer in Christ Jesus, you are equipped with the power of the Holy Spirit, with the Word of God, to share the gospel with somebody. Amen.
Yeah.
And the Bible said that we should not be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Sometimes we think we're inadequate, we don't know enough, or we're too prideful, we're too arrogant. But we got to realize that as a child of God, we should be equipped and be prayerful at every given moment to share the gospel with someone.
Amen.
You know, and just keep this in mind that We all have different circles of friends, circles of influence. You can reach people, I cannot. I can reach people, you cannot. So part of the purpose, as Paul was sharing, that we all get a purpose to build the kingdom of God. Never disqualify yourself for what, for how much you don't know. Just know that through Christ you can do all things. Through Him you have everything that you need. He has equipped you, but you've got to pick up that mantle and say, God, equip me more with wisdom and understanding, the power of the Holy Spirit, so I can go and minister to people that I come in contact with. Amen? And if you hear this word and you don't do nothing about it, you're accountable. Watch me. Because the Bible says when you hear the gospel, He equips you. Now it's our responsibility to bring forth the word, to equip other people, to encourage them. Amen? I don't walk around thinking I'm better than anybody. I come alongside any of you guys. If you need help, you need encouragement, you need prayer, you let us know. Because we are about building the kingdom of God. Not about building this church or that church. We're building the kingdom of God together as a team. Because at the end, what is all about the end of our life is to be present with the Lord. Amen? If you think you can live forever on earth, then you're serving the wrong God. That's just how I preach, sorry. I'm not dumb. I'll tell you like it is. All these guys, you're weird. Yeah? No, I'm not weird. I open and I speak with love. Yeah. I speak in compassion because I believe everybody in here is called and appointed and anointed by God. Yeah. But are you willing to step up and say, God, here I am. Use me. If you say you're not ready, then check yourself. Amen. I need to be still encouraging. I just want that to encourage all of us. Because in this room, you have different age groups. I believe there's different faith levels. There's different ways that you were brought up. But you all have something in you to honor God. Never think that you have to be perfect. Because when I came to God, I never come to God perfect. I came to God with my scars, with my tattoos, with my history, with my past. But I realized that somebody that loved me so much and forgave me for my sins, that died for my sins, I had to surrender my life. Because I was kind of like gangster, doing stupid things in the road before. Drug dealing, collecting money, running chicken fights, the bar scenes. Not that I was a drinker or a drug user, but I was one of those enforcer guys. That was my identity in the world. But I realized while I was walking in the world and doing these things, something was tugging at my heart saying, that's not you. But I kept pursuing this thing that I thought it was my identity. And so I got sick and tired of doing what I was doing, and I started walking away from the worldly stuff and turning to God. Then I felt things falling off my life. And I began to experience the freedom of God, knowing that that wasn't my identity. He has called me to do what I do now. Sharing the gospel, bringing hope to people.
Amen.
We've ministered along with Pastor and his wife, the homeless people, the broken families, lost teens and youths. We went all over the place in our own way of sharing the gospel. And coming here, I just pray and hope that you guys step one step of faith and say, God, here I am. Use me how you see fit. And believe me, God will use you. Amen?
Amen.
Well, I don't want plenty of money. You don't need money. You need faith. I don't want a car. You don't want gas. I don't want gas. You don't want a car. But I can borrow a couple of dollars. Or, Lord, provide me. I can share with you guys miracles that God performed through our ministry that you freak out. I had one nephew that lived by Guam that was in Wainai one time. He forgot his wallet. He drove from Wainai to Wailoa without gas. And all he did was cry. He called me up, Uncle, I felt God in my car. And I was just worshiping Him, and I drove all the way home without gas in my car. This is one of the many examples that we see how God moved. And if we serve the same God, you need to step up in faith and say, okay, God, if this is you, then I gotta take another step of faith. Amen. Because did God raise the dead?
Yes.
Did He cause a blind to see?
Yeah,
did He cause a lame to walk?
Yeah,
did He cast out demons?
Yes, He did.
Are we children of God?
Yes.
So why can't we do the same thing?
Amen.
Why can't we do the same thing? Amen.
Amen.
Oh, this guy giving me cracks. I never heard this message before. I said, yes, I said this in love. And it carries all of me forth. Amen. Because there's people in here I see that God has called. And I'm not going to call you out right now, but God will call you. It's up to you to say, God, here I am. Like, God, you want to go. You called, you're anointed by God. It's up to you to take this step of faith. Because He gave you the Holy Spirit, that's all you need. All the other stuff will fall in place. Father, I thank you, Lord, for this opportunity to share this brief message of love and hope to your people here on this special day, Lord God. I pray you cover this message with your precious blood. Cover these families here that is here today, Lord God, with your precious blood. Bless each and every one of them, Lord God, and provoke them into good works, and they will glorify you, Father God. And that they will be the sunlight of this earth, to let people know that there is hope through Christ Jesus. I thank you, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Love you, family. Have a blessed day.
Amen.
Spirit descended on us at the time of Pentecost, and if you're open to it, you never know where that Holy Spirit will take you and what words you will hear. So thank you both for sharing your messages. It is now time for our offering. Would our ushers please come forward? Thank you offering from Ross and Florence Damani. a birthday offering for Marvin Hechtel from Haley, Logan, Chloe, and Carol, and finally a prayer offering for Cassidy from Daniel, Judy, and Cassidy, Hernandez, Tamayo. And thank you all for your gifts and your generosity.
Father God, we just thank you. Thank you for the hands, the many gifts that you have given us, God, that we give right back to you. Father God, we just thank you, and we just lift up the families here, the friends and families over here in this beautiful church, God, we lift them up to you, Lord God, continue to bless them, hold their families and their lives, God. Continue to bless this church and this ministry, Lord God, and they just lift up this offering to you, Lord God, to bless it and multiply it. In the name of Jesus.
Announcements. Thank you, Pastor George Keamo and Mrs. Lana Keamo and your guests who you brought up and to their families for joining us and sharing the Word of God to us today. Next, summertime is the right time to prepare for the next school year, and so it's time for blessings in a bag. Let's help out our cakey in church and in the North Shore community by donating school supplies between now and July 23rd. Walmart and other stores are happy to help us. Prices are super low right now, so it's a great time to pick up any of the following: pencils, markers, erasers, paper, index cards, post-it notes, calculators, spiral notebooks, three-ring notebooks, backpacks, and place your supplies in the collection box located in the foyer. And you'll bring a smile to our cakey spaces. Mahalo for your donations from your church Ohana. Calendar events. Today, on June 23rd, we have a property team meeting. On Tuesday, the Tuesday market is closed this week. The next market will take place on July 23rd. On Wednesday, June 26th, the Bible study from 10 to 11 will take place in the admin building. All are welcome to attend. On Sunday, June 30th, the altar flowers will be from Michelle Sagai's side in honor of her birthday. The worship leader will be Sil Andres. Our guest pastor will be Makoa Gomez. I'm not sure I'm saying that correctly. Yes. On Sunday, July 7th, the fellowship committee meeting in the admin building. They will have a meeting in the admin building following the worship service. The guest pastor will be Reverend Lauren Buck Medeiros. Sunday, July 14th, finance meeting, deacons meeting, guest pastor, Reverend Lauren Buck Medeiros. Sunday, July 21st, the deacon articles are due. So this covers past events from May, June, and July, and upcoming calendar events including August, September, and October. There will also be a council meeting, and the guest speaker will be Brian Crowley III. Saturday, August 3rd, awards of the Sherwin Gervasio Memorial Scholarship will be presented at a banquet to honor recipients held in the social hall at 10 a.m. Tickets are available for $30. Donations for silent auction greatly appreciated. If interested, please contact Alan or Michelle Sagasta. And are there any further announcements at this time? Then it is time for us to stand for our closing hymn.
Thank you.
It's going to be the first time I'm doing benedictions. You know what? Today's word is just about you have a purpose, you have a calling. And it's amazing. You guys are an amazing family, an amazing group. And you guys, like, we'll see that you guys all have calling. You guys have all purposes. You guys have purposes. Mm-hmm. It's not just to live our life, but to live our life in Christ. That they may see your good works, glorify your Father, which is in heaven. It's just an amazing, beautiful Sunday up here. Why do it? Related to why not? Such a blessing. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Sorry, just Father God, we just thank you. Thank you for this amazing Sunday. Amazing meeting our beautiful family, our brothers and sisters in Christ in Waialua, Lord God. Father God, lift up this church, Lord God, continue to pour into them, Lord God, that they may pour out, Lord God. And Father God, as they await the incoming of Pastor EJ, Lord God, Father God, continue to bless them, continue to shape them, continue to mold them, Lord God, into who you have called us to be sons and daughters of the living God. Father God, and that we know that we have a purpose, Lord God, and our purpose is in you. And we just thank you for loving us, Lord God. Father God, we just thank you for all that you have done, still doing, for what you are about to do in our lives, in our home, in our ministries, in our church, Lord God. I lift up everyone here and now to bless them, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.